Hi YouTube, it's Rose, and I pray all is well with your soul this day, and I am making this video to talk about December 25th, which is the day that most people recognize the birth of Jesus Christ, God come in the flesh. And this Christmas, me and my family got together, and it was in Monterey, California. And I just have to share that the drive there was so breathtaking, so amazing, that it had me in tears like two or three times. I know at least a couple of times, maybe even more. And I drove like at the last hour and a half before sunset, and what a gift God gave me. I just want to praise His holy name, for even in this valley of darkness, we always could see the hand of God. Amen. I just love you, Jesus. Okay, and then I would like to talk about my family a little bit. Right now, my family's pretty small. It's just me and my sister. And my father passed away when I was 26. My brother passed away when he was 42. So I was like 30. We're 5 years difference. 37. And my mom passed away about 2.5 years ago, something like that. Well, my father and my brother were the most amazing people I've ever met on this planet in my time. They were so kind, so generous, so loving, so forgiving. And the reason I share this with you is because I want you to know that when I share stories or testimony, it's not because I'm a weak person. I just don't know how to be or stay angry at anybody or how not to be forgiving. I just was not, that's not that tree I come from. I'm an apple that fell from the tree, and the tree I came from was a father that was a believer in Jesus Christ. He did not believe in institutional churches. He took us to missions and stuff. He loved to travel. And we would go to missions, and he would go in there, you know, when there was no service or anything, and he would go pray on his own. And I know he prayed daily, and so did my mother. My mother was Catholic, but when we were children, I remember going to a Catholic church, but it was all in Spanish, and we moved from Los Angeles, California, when I was 7. So that was the last I knew about church. And my personal walk with Christ as a child, excuse me, my personal walk with Christ as a child, I just remember my family always believing in Jesus. God was mentioned daily. Like every time we eat, my father would say, gracias a Dios, which means thank you, God. You know, thanks to God. We have eaten, and you know, it wasn't traditional, or it wasn't like a Bible-believing home, but it was a daily, I see my dad walk the walk, and my brother, and my mom, too, but my mom was a very strong person. She didn't, she could endure. She endured, and she was strong, and she was loyal. She was just a wonderful mother, and I was so blessed to come from the family I did. But the only ones I have left in my immediate family is my sister. So it was me and my sister. We got together with my children, which I have 3, and her children, which she has 2. And we had the most amazing time in Monterey. I was so blessed, and I pray that the Lord has blessed you too. I received a new t-shirt that says blessed, which I'm so grateful for, because I had this old white t-shirt that said blessed, and it was getting old and raggedy, but I got a new one, and of course we have our blessed hoodies and stuff. My niece works for a company that makes these clothing, and Okay, so as a child, I believed in Jesus, and I remember running to the Jesus movies, and I was just glued to the TV whenever there was a Jesus movie, and I remember the most powerful part of the whole movie for me was when he would speak the Sermon on the Mount. Excuse me. And I know that was literally written in my heart because I grew up with that. But I know the importance now of reading the whole scriptures because we must have all the word in us, not just one part of it. Because I learned to be an incredibly forgiving person. I forgive anybody for everything, period. And so that can run into troubles. So now, as I'm older, I understand I have more wisdom, and God has given me more wisdom, and I know that we're not to let people walk all over us. So if there's a problem with someone, yes, I forgive them, and then I go on to continue my life with the Lord. So. But back in the day when I was young, I thought it meant forgive the person and let them hurt you, keep them in your life and just keep forgiving them and forgiving them. That's called abuse, and I learned that. Excuse me. So it's like I said, it's important to know the whole Bible. Sorry about the commercial. Okay. So, I grew up as a believer as a child, but when I broke my neck, I had just turned 40, 41, something like that. And that's when I started reading the Bible, and I started going to church. And I went to the Seventh-day Adventist church, so nobody throw rocks. I don't go to the SDA church anymore. I think the last time I went was about 2 years ago. Me and my kids, there's this really beautiful small SDA church. Is the only one I would go to. I went to one larger one once. I never did that again. But it's in the foothills of the Sierras, and I know the people that go there. And that was the first time I almost fell asleep at church. It was a seriously, I had to see a message. So, anyways. But I'm praying for each and every one of us. I think we're all in our walk, and that's actually what I'm talking about with this video is after I broke my neck, I started reading the Bible, going to church, but I knew nothing but miracles and wonders. All I knew was I believed and I had faith. That's all I knew, and I was starting to read a book that I did not understand except for maybe. I would read Psalms and Proverbs, and then I'd go back to all the other books. But in 2009, 2008, 2009, I'm sorry, 2009, 2010, everything started to change. And by 2011, my eyes were opened. God called me, and I started searching the truth out, and I started finding out about, how everything I ever learned in my life is a lie, and that we are in the end time. And I never had any knowledge prior about the church leaving or pre-trib, post-trib, all that. I never knew any of that. I never even knew about the rapture. I was just a believer. I read the Bible. I was just trying to get through life. And then now it's all about revelation and knowledge and to a lot of people in and I don't know. This is what I want to make this video about. Christians that hate Christians and that kick them out of their churches, or they look down upon them, or call them names like witch, or tell them you have a demon in you. Now, I think we all kind of know what people look and act like when they have demons in them. They're addicted to drugs, they're addicted to anger, they're addicted to, they convulse. There all kinds of really strange things happen. They murder and hurt people. So for a Christian to tell a Christian, and kick them out of the church for what they believe they have reason for, and then start name calling or speaking behind their back, that's not good. I pray that I don't do that. When I talk about things after the fact, it's because I need a witness as to what is happening, so that I know that what I'm doing is right with God. That's my my desire, and that's why I'm doing that if I do speak. But I would never say anything that I will not say in front of somebody's face. Really. Okay, so I mean, if they ask, anyways, I don't just volunteer information on what I think of people. So, anyways, with that, I would just like to say that for my life and my walk with God, where I'm at now is dead in the flesh, in fear of the Lord, redeemed by the blood of Jesus Christ that he shed on Calvary. I am saved by grace with the word, writing the word in my heart. Amen. So I pray the same for everyone else, and I just wanted to share with everybody. That's it. A little too long. I'll try to edit. I love each and every one of you, and thank you for your precious time for those that are still with me. Give me a thumbs up and subscribe. Thanks. Bye.